Hello everyone, we're here today in DaVinci Resolve 18. We're going to make a simple door transition, like you're walking from inside the house out. So we'll bring down our media. This is a recording I made of my bedroom door actually. We have to start with making a copy of this. For those of you that don't know me, I have to use this on-screen keyboard. So it does get in the way a little bit, but it won't that much in this tutorial. Due to health reasons, so that's why it's up there. So hold down the Alt key and slide that up to line 3. Bring down your other video of the outside. Disable track 1 and 2 for now. Select number 3 and go down to color tab. And let's go on a color page. Bring your playhead over to where the doors open some. And down here we're going to use the magic mask. So you want to make sure that is selected. Give you a quick rundown of the tools. This button here is for object. This is for persons. We're not doing persons, so we're going to leave it on objects. Then you have a minus dauber and a plus dauber. Plus dauber is where you want to mask. Minus is where you don't. Then you have an invert, so you could just flip-flop everything. And then you have a mask overlay, which shows where the mask is. Then you have two options for tracking. You have faster and better. If you have a powerful enough machine and it'll run on better, I suggest using it. Then we have the tracking options. Where I'm at right now is tracking forward and backward. This is tracking forward and tracking backward. So we're going to start with we're going to select this plus dauber. And we're going to write on wherever we want to mask. I can select this overlay button. Takes a minute sometimes for the AI to do its thing. There we go. Now where it's red is where it's mask. Now we'll go ahead and track it. Okay, now we have a solid blue line with a green check arrow indicating it's a good track. turn the overlay off and go back up in the edit page. Before we do that, go up to the notepad, right click, select add alpha output. It'll make this little blue dot. It'll connect the square dot to the blue, or the blue square dot to the round one. Now we can go up to the edit page. Turn these other two tracks back on. And I see we have a little issue right here in the corner. So we'll go back down to the color page. This is where you want to select the minus dobber. This can be hit or miss, but usually you can get them out. Sometimes takes a few tries. This should be the last one. There's a little more there. This is still a lot better than rotoscoping this whole thing. And it doesn't always happen. All right, we'll go back to the edit page and see how it looks. Could if I let that one go, would have been noticeable. Okay, you see these black edges? You can get them out. All these controls are here. You got clean black, clean white, radius, all these settings. I'm not going to do it for the sake of the tutorial. It does take a little time playing with them. But if you want to clean it up, just play with everything and you can get it figured out. Okay, back up to the edit page. We're going to animate this center clip. Go up in the inspector, select dynamic zoom, turn it on, and then click on dynamic zoom, and another box will pop up where it says swap. Select that. Go over the bottom left of the screen on the transform. Click on the arrow down. And then select dynamic zoom. You'll have two boxes showing the viewer. The inner red one is the one that's going to be where you're zooming out to. We want to make it look like we're actually walking through the door. Smaller you make it, the farther it's going to continue out. If you don't already have the render cache on, be sure to go up to playback, render cache, and select smart mode. Let's see how it looks. Play it one more time. Well, there you go. That's how you make a door transition. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.